Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome longtime CAALA member Michael Bidart.
Good evening. Let me begin by thanking the executive officers and the members of the distinguished board of this wonderful organization. Thank you for your years of service. Thank you for your friendship to our firm. And thank you for being so good to Ricardo Echeverria. Ricardo, for you to be awarded tonight is very special, not only because of your achievements and your most deserving work over these years, which has culminated in this most prestigious award that I think this organization gives to a trial lawyer. And to receive it on a night when you are joining the likes of the other award recipients tonight, you should, and I know you are, very, very proud. These are the kind of evenings where you wish you could single out everybody here that means so much to you, to thank you and to try to show in some feeble way the respect and the admiration that you have for them. But I think you know how I personally feel and how our firm collectively feels about those people who have made this night so special. So thank you very much. This night is especially important to me because as I was standing backstage waiting, I was just thinking what it must be like for Ricardo's parents, Juan and Dolores, who are here tonight, to see this. And as you can tell from the disproportionate amount of noise coming from that side of the room, that many of Ricardo's cousins, his aunts and uncles, from Bakersfield and from Chino, there's never been so many Basques in Beverly Hills in one night, I assure you. And so, also, tonight, the very first time when Garo mentioned that this was the first time that this award was given the name of Charlie B. O'Reilly, how appropriate, because those of us who knew and loved Charlie O'Reilly, and when I saw his photograph up there a while ago, it brought a tear to my eye. Charlie was a natural-born trial lawyer, incomparable. And Ricardo is a natural-born trial lawyer, so it couldn't be more fitting. But I couldn't come up here all the way to Beverly Hills from Chino and not tell a little story on Ricardo. My wife Jeanette and I have known Ricardo since he was a little boy there on the dairy in Chino with his parents and his older brother Javier. And my first memory that I knew that Ricardo had it, he was going to have it no matter what he did. Of all of the qualities of a trial lawyer, I think the two most important qualities are a healthy self-image, self-esteem, so that you're comfortable in front of a jury and you can be convincing and persuasive, not nervous, and also to be able to think on your feet, because all of you wonderful trial lawyers in this room, many of whom have given Ricardo a lot of lessons by example, because he used to go around the courthouse every time he knew one of you was trying a case to soak it all in, because he was like a sponge. But those qualities of a healthy self-image and being quick on your feet and being able to think quickly on your feet, Ricardo demonstrated to us when he was only 10 years old. One of the rare afternoons where his parents took a day off or an afternoon off to go down to the local Basque restaurant to have lunch with their family, they were chatting afterwards, and Ricardo was only 10 years old. He was bored. And so he walked outside, he was walking around the parking lot, and he picked up a piece of scrap metal and he was playing with it. And then he walked over behind his parents' the first brand new car they had ever owned. It was a new Chevy Impala, dark green. And he stood there looking at the parents' car, and the trunk lid right above the key. And you know, everybody knows Ricardo's kind of a frustrated artist to begin with. So he took out that scrap metal and he started to carve his initials in the trunk lid of his parents' new car. A big R and a big E. And then he didn't stop there. He put "is best." "Yes, yes!" exclamation point. Ricardo was 10 years old, so pretty healthy self-image already. He went back in and he had no idea that what he did was dreadfully wrong. He went home that afternoon and he and his brother Javier got home and they changed into their work clothes, went out to feed the calves. Father went into the milk house to clean up the milk barn for the next milking. And out of nowhere, he hears this scream coming from the barn. And his father comes storming out, comes running out to Ricardo, grabs him by the arm, and he's yelling at him all the way back. Ricardo has no appreciation of what he had done. And as he's getting closer, they're going to the garage, and his father's pointing to the artwork on the back of the Chevy, and he's screaming at him, and Ricardo realized that what he had done was not good. So he says, "Oh, father," or "Aita, that wasn't me, that was Cousin Raymond." Now, Raymond Echeverria is here tonight, and those of us who know Raymond know that he would have never done that. And so, this was how Ricardo first, and I think it was appropriate because Ricardo learned when he was a child that his brother Javier was named after the Basque patron saint, Saint Francis Xavier, San Francisco Javier. And Ricardo says, "Mommy, who was I named after?" And she said, "Richard Nixon." That's a true story. Ricardo was born in 1968 when Richard Nixon was running for that landslide victory. And these people were living the American dream, and they wanted their son maybe to be president someday. Can you imagine that the trial lawyer of the year for the Consumer Attorneys of Los Angeles is named after Richard Nixon? In closing, to be honest, I've had a little bit of guilt over the years because Ricardo called me up when he was in his last year of college at San Luis Obispo, where he was a student body president. And he said, "You know, Mike, I'm thinking of applying to law school." And I knew for sure that his parents had aspirations that Ricardo would join them and Javier to come back and continue to expand the dairy business and to continue the fine operation they had begun. And that was their dream. That's what they had worked so hard for. So it was a complete surprise and shock to Juan and Dolores that their son decided to go this other direction. I felt some responsibility because he came with us, and I said, "Boy, this better work out because otherwise they're going to be upset with me." Effective tonight, I'm no longer apologetic, and I have no guilt. And so, Mr. Ricardo Echeverria, if you would please join me up here, I'd like to present you this award. I was telling my dear partner, Bill Shernoff, earlier this evening that of all the very special moments we've had, and we've had our share, and we've enjoyed the moments that we've had with all of you as you've experienced your trials, tribulations, big moments, good moments, and bad moments. We've been together with all of you. No moment has been more special in my career than this moment. And I mean that from the bottom of my heart. And so, Ricardo, in the presence of all of our friends here tonight, the esteemed members of the California Supreme Court, both past and present, the courts of appeal, both past and present, all of the wonderful Superior Court judges, past and present, some of whom are now doing mediations, I am extremely honored and pleased to present you with the Consumer Attorneys Association of Los Angeles Charlie O'Reilly Memorial Award Trial Lawyer of the Year 2010.